Morning, everybody. We're learning Ways of Tzaddikim, the Hebrew version. Page Ein Zain, Az. Courageous kind of Az. It's Azut. Usually the wicked people have Azut. Azut is, I forgot the name in English. It's not a good trait, but you also have Azut the Kedusha. When a person, like what Pinchas did, he broke all the rules.
Zealousy.
Yeah, it's almost, you can say, it's not zealousy. No, zealousy is what came out of it. But azut is like when you, let's say there's an argument about the Torah, and you don't make any calculation, and you bring the honor of the Torah up. It's like the azut of Kedusha. If a wicked person have it, and he chutzpan, that's a chutzpan of Tamid Chacham, or doesn't have any respect to old people, az panim legeenom, Chachamim says, as panim legenom, person of azut is going to gehenom, to hell. But if a person of azut de kedusha, it's positive. That's the only trait when azut is kedusha.
So what's like an anger?
I have to
like
open
fiery,
the...
like fiery personality?
Maybe. Because after this, maybe we'll look Hebrew, English, and I'll tell you. So Amud Ein Zayin. Today is lesson 46, according to my counting. I'm doing it because I'm recording it, even though you're changing it on the website, just so we have a kind of continuation. Even if we made a mistake, you name it the way that it should be. So later on, we make Bezat Hashem CD production, Mirtze Hashem, Zaket Arabim, all of us. So then the numbers that you put online. So this is part number 6 of the show, lesson 46, part 6, the gate of Simcha. And with no further stopping. Disruption, you said yes. So we learned the gate of Simcha yesterday. Last time we learned that a righteous person, a person of Simcha, one of the traits of Simcha is to understand and agree with everything that comes to you. So here says, "Ach, haderech sheimtza haadam bechelko." The way that a person should be happy in his portion. This is how we should do it. Shikabel besimcha ra kmo atov, that he should accept with goodness, with happiness, I'm sorry, the negative things that comes upon him according to his understanding, because everything is positive. Just as he accept the good things, just as you accept the bonus, you should accept when you get fired, chas b'shalom. So when you get fired, at least the way that I think is, I never really sink into why, maybe a little bit. The most important thing is, how do I find another job? Immediately, when I hear a fire, another job, something happened, solution. When you think solution, you agree with the situation, you think solution, trying to find. Somebody spoke bad about me, how do I recover from this? Somebody insulted me, how do I make peace, or how do I keep distance from him? Depends what the calculation, immediately look for calculation.
But don't
meaning I accept the situation, what the Hashem put me into, and I find out to get out of it, solution.
But don't we need to find out why, so we learn not to do to make the same mistake?
Yes, of course. It's happening in an instant. Right away you're thinking, what happened? What did I do? Why did I get fired? And of course, let's say I did something wrong. I came late too many times. The boss warned me, for example. How do I find another job? Oh, maybe I can get back into the job. But not to say why and all the time. Don't put too much attention. Why it happened? I'm bitter. I don't agree with the situation. Think solution. I gave an example of that in a situation you think you can control. Chas v'shalom, a person can have an accident. He buy a brand new car the first day, he hit something, he damaged the car, and he doesn't have deductible. There was no insurance. Okay, example. What can I do? Kaparat avonot, I'll fix the car somehow and I'll continue. So I agree with the situation that happened to you. It's very difficult. That's a part of Simcha. Haderech hazeh mitchalek lekama drachim. This way divides to few routes. Ha'echad, the approach of accepting the bad things that comes to upon your life or comes to your life, just as you accept the good things, it's dividing to few routes with this approach. One, ahad, tzarich gader gadol shiftach be'elohim, be'elokim. You need a big fence to guard yourself, to stay in bitachon, trust in Hashem, and not to exit the route of bitachon. Like you play bowling, sometimes I play bowling with the kids and they put those railings, you know, for people who don't know how to play. I love those. You can use the railings to, even sometimes you see, you go on angle, but you still get what you need. So you put railings in your life, that's gader actually. put railing in your life not ever to go out of the bitachon in Hashem. Okay, I don't understand, I'm lost, I'm sad, I'm happy, whatever, I'm stressed, but Hashem is here. Hashem guards me. You can't get out of this. If you get out of this, you get out of Avodat Hashem. Asheni, the second route, Ha'emunah, the faith. Same thing, put yourself bumpers not to get out of faith. And no matter what you do, don't get out of faith. Sometimes we go a little bit extreme. Sometimes we blame a person for a situation, but then reset yourself. Who is he? Nobody's nothing. Hashem is Elohim. He says when he spoke about the trust, he said, "Viftach be'Elohim in Hashem." Like we say in Yom Kippur, remember 7 times, Hashem hu Elohim. God is the authority. Remember, everything happened. Hashem is. That's a part of Emunah. Of course, it's also bitachon is Hashem is Elohim. But when it comes to Emunah, don't forget that Hashem is also Elohim, and from this build new Emunah. New faith. You have to have bitachon and faith. Bitachon and faith. When you have bitachon, you create new faith. And when you last, faith will also bring you back to bitachon. Faith in Hashem will bring you back to trust in Hashem. Ashlishi, the third route is the sechel, the mind, the calculation. So in these elements, you are keeping in simcha, even though you're accepting the less good things or the bad things in simcha. Just as you accept the good things, Ashlishi is like you say, sechel, with your mind, find terutzim, find reasoning why Hashem brought this to you, and continue. Arevi, and don't fall. Arevi, the fourth one, istapkut. The feel good with what you got. I don't know the fancy word in English. Be happy with what you contempt, right? Be content.
Satisfied.
Be satisfied. Yeah, the trait of satisfaction. Be satisfied. You wanted to buy something, somebody else bought it. In real estate, it happens a lot. You want to buy something, you put so much effort in it, you really want it, you traveled, you saw it, it's mine. Before you buy something, you have to feel that it's yours already. If not, you don't have the urge to buy. You want to buy it, you lost it. What can you do? There's a lot of people wanted to buy it, you lost it, move on. What can you do? This guy made a mistake, the broker made a mistake, it's just not meant to be yours. Just move on. Or it could be nothing. You lost the client, somebody else took the client. Anything in life, this personal, whatever. Amar Chacham, the Chacham says, the Chacham, the wise man says, Mifchar ha'pnenim b'shar ha'emunah, in the pnenim, in the pearls, in the gate of emunah. I'm not sure who is the Rav. Mifchar ha'pnenim b'shar ha'emunah. I'm not sure what this book is. Forgive me. Kol adam tzarich gader. וסעד וסמך כדי שיתקיימו מעשיו הטובים. Every person says the Rav in that book. Every person needs a fence, a sad, a help like the old people have a cane, or help, assistant, וסמך. And somebody to help him, to trust him, to be able to trust something or somebody, Hashem, כדי שיתקיימו מעשיו הטובים. So his good actions will be able to exist. ומהו הגדר? And what is the fence? זהו הביטחון, it's the trust. What's the fence? The fence is the trust. Trust in Hashem. שהבוטח תמיד באלוקים יתברך. Says here, Rav, a fact. A person who trusts הקדוש ברוך הוא will be blessed. Sorry, שהבוטח תמיד באלוקים. A person who always trusts Hashem, he will be blessed. כמו שנאמר, like it says in the book of תהילים נוני כחב גימל, אשלך על השם יאהבך ויחלקה לך. It's a very, very big secret in Avodat Hashem. Ashlech, it's a pasuk in Tehillim. We read it. Ashlech al Hashem yavcha. Throw on Hashem your worries, your not sure in life, the things that you don't feel like you out of control, or even if you feel the things that you feel in control, but you know Hashem is running the world. Throw it to Hashem, and He will kalkelecha, and He will take care of you. Just as a kid when you're young, your dad, you don't know how to swim. Your father tells you, jump to the pool, I'll take you. And you really don't know your purpose, but you trust your father. Or you jump in the back to the pool, and you trust that somebody will catch you. Somebody, a good friend of yours. If he doesn't, or there's sometimes you go climbing, and there's a point when you have to trust your friend to give you your hand. If not, you can fall from there. There's many things in when you go climbing on mountains. You have to trust that he's going to grab your hand. If you lose your hand, Samchad b'shalom, a person can fall. Trust Hashem like this, and He will take care of you. Person should say in the tefillah, Hashem, I trust you, everything I own is yours, I trust you to take care of me, I trust you to give me health and parnasa and happiness and to help me with this issue, with this. So I trust you. Please help me. In your own speed, in the timing that you think is right. You should, person should not say, Hashem, I prayed 20 times. What happened? Why you didn't fulfill it? Moshe Rabbeinu prayed 515 times to enter, I think, Israel. Hashem told him, stop. And Moshe stopped. Umau geder habitachon. What's the fence of? Now we explain what is the geder. We explain. Let me see. We explain what is this fence? Is the trust in Hashem? And then we explain if it's trust Hashem, you will be blessed. And then we explain that you should throw to Hashem all your worries, and He will take care of you. Umau geder habitachon. And what's the fence of trust? איזה דבר מביא שיפתח האדם באלוהים? What advice? What is the fence of trust? Like we say bumpers, like bumpers in bowling. What's the bumpers to keep the fence of trust? איזה דבר מביא שיפתח האדם באלוהים? What thing? What way? What approach brings a person that should trust הקדוש ברוך הוא? זוהי האמונה, it's fate. Like we said, if you don't have ביטחון, think, I want to have emunah pshuta. One second, I'm a Jew. There's Hashem. My grandfather believed. Any trick, anything you can think of. My grandfather believed in Hashem. If I go back, we believed in God, in Hashem. We kept Shabbat. We're keeping Shabbat now. I have trust in Hashem. Hashem running the world. When you think like this in emunah, it creates bitachon. Mitoch shema'amin babore. From the fact that you trust, that you believe in Hashem, that you have faith in Hashem, שכל הצלחתו בעולם הזה, בעולם הבא, הכל הוא ממנו ואין אחרי זולתו. From the fact that you trust the Kadosh Baruch Hu, and all of your succeedings in this world, and the world to come, everything is from Hashem and nobody else. This is the foundation of Judaism. נותן ליבו לאהבה אותו בכל לבבו. Think like that, and it gives you love to love Kadosh Baruch Hu in all your heart. When you think like that, everything I have is from Hashem. All the successes I have from Hashem. Even all the failures is from Hashem. Hashem will set me this world, the world to come. I have to follow His Torah. I have to have trust in, faith in Him. From that you will build trust. And from that, says Rav, the Rav here, Noten libo le'ava oto b'chol levavo. It brings you to the ultimate, which is love HaKadosh Baruch Hu with all your heart. Shema Yisrael v'avtat Hashem Elokecha. It's the foundation of Judaism. ומהו גדר האמונה, says the Rav here, before we spoke about the fence of ביטחון. Now we elaborate. What's the גדר האמונה? What's the fence of אמונה or faith? איזה דבר מביא אדם לידי אמונה שלמה? What way, what approach brings a person to have a complete אמונה, complete faith in Hashem? הוא שלא יתנועע מדבר רע. It's that you're not gonna shake, you're not gonna move away from something bad. Meaning, if that's the path that you need to go, don't lose your path because of something bad. That's what it means. Don't run away from, why? Because it's the path to success. It's the path to success. You have to work hard to achieve something. You have to work hard to make tshuva. You have to work hard and sometimes you get rebuked, but you know, this is the way. Don't get away from this. Don't shake from this. Continue. Shikabel kol haba alav besimcha. Accept everything that comes upon you in happiness. וזה דומה לעבד שמכיר אדונה, that's similar to a slave who knows his master, והוא נדיב ורחמן, that he knows his master is merciful and a man of chesed. Merciful and, I don't know how נדיב, a person likes to give, generous. Yeah. A slave who knows his master, he knows his master is generous and merciful. הוא משען ועושה רצונו ושליחותו שכר גדול, and he pays to the person who do his will and his message, big reward. הוא בעד שיחביד על משרתיו עבודה קשה. I'm sorry. And the master pays לעושה רצונו ששליחותו שלך. He pays to the people who do his will and his, when he sends them to do a message as messengers, he pays them big rewards to do his will. הוא בעד שיחביד על משרתיו עבודה קשה ומטיב להם טובות גדולות. And the fact that he gives his workers His servants very hard work, he gives them very big favors and reward. ומגדלם נסם, and he brings them up and he gives them honor. ויהיו אנשי הצעתו, and they will be the people of his advice. ואוכלים על שולחנו, they eat on his table. ומרכיבם במרכבת המשנה אשר לו, and he rides them in the carriage that he has, the secondary carriage of the king. He gives them a lot of honor if they do his will. ומפקידם על ארצו, and he makes them governors on his land. אין ספק, there's no doubt, if there's such a master, I'm adding the words, says here the Rav, אין ספק, there's no doubt שזה העבד היודע ומכיר אדונו. There's no doubt that this servant who knows his master, that he has such a good traits, like we explained, שיעזוב כל מה שבעולם ויעשה רצון אדוניו בשמחה. This kind of servant who understands the quality of his master, he will leave everything in the world and will do the will of his master with happiness. Why? He will lift me up, he will recognize my hard work, he will honor me. ואף אם העבודה קשה עליו מאוד, and even if the work is very difficult on him, בזכור הטובה אשר תגיע אליו בכלל העבודה הזאת, when he remember the good, the payment that his master will give him for his hard work, אבל העבד, אבל העבד הרואה בשאדוניו מקפח שכר עבדה, but on the other end, a master, a servant who see that his master doesn't pay his servants or the people who do favors him accordingly, וידע בליבו שאדוניו קהילי ותרחו יותר גדול בשכרו, and he knows that his master will make him work harder than actually what he pays him. אין זה העבד תורח לאדוניו קים בצוון. This servant only worked hard for his master with sadness, because he knows that he's not going to get rewarded, not even honor, not even good food, not even to lift him up and give him honor, nothing, not even payment. כן הוא, enough. כן הוא העניין הזה. Same thing on this matter. המאמין אמונה שלמה ביוצאו. A person who have complete faith within his master. Sorry, in Hashem. Same as this story, the parable is. A person who knows that Hashem will pay, that have a complete faith in his master, in Hashem. שהוא מטיב ומרחם יותר מכל מרחם, that Hashem is giving goodness and merciful more than anybody else in this world. ושהוא דיין אמת, that Hashem is a judge of truth, וכל מה שעושה לו, הכל הוא לטובתו, and whatever Hashem does to you, to us, it's everything for our ultimate goodness, ולתן לו שכר גדול, and he will give you a big reward, על כל מה שסובל לשמוע גדול, for everything you suffer for Hashem's big name, ועל כל העבודה והשירות שיעשה לשם שמיים, and all the work and the service that you do לשם שמיים, for the sake of Hashem, praying, mitzvot, chesed, shalom bayit, everything you do, hard work, not working in Shabbat, putting tefillin every day, learning Torah, of course, ישיג לו נעימות גדולה בעולם הנעים. Hashem will give him very big pleasantness in the pleasant world. Maybe it's talking about the world to come. I'm thinking, כעניין שמציל מנבוכדנצר, like we find נבוכדנצר, עבור שפסע ארבע פסיעות לכבוד הקל, נבוכדנצר, even though he was a wicked person, because he stepped four steps in honor of Hashem, התברך, הנה לפה השם מייבלס, זכה לגדולה גדולה. He won a very big, sorry, a very big greatness. That says in Sanhedrin de Gemara, Sanhedrin צדיק וו, עמוד א', וכעניין שמצינו בעשיו, sorry, it's very long, וכעניין שמצינו בעשיו, like we find in עשיו הרשע, of course, עבור שנזר בכבוד אביו, זכה גדולה בעולם הזה. Even עשיו that was wicked, since he was careful in the honor of his father, he won a big greatness in this world. וזרוע אחריו, him and his seeds after him, וכן רבים and many others who gave respect to Hashem, even small respect, and even if they're wicked, Hashem doesn't eliminate any goodness for any, I'm sorry, any reward, even for a wicked person does something good. קל וחומר us, what we are children of Hashem, if we do something and we suffer the difficulty coming to prayer on time, eating kosher, trying to correct our traits, things that we do as Jews to satisfy Hashem, of course he's going to give us 10 payment, one sentence, אין ספק בהיות האדם מאמין בכל זה בלב שלם, there's no doubt when a person believing this with a complete heart, ודאי ישמח בכל דין השם בך, of course he's going to be happy, whatever Hashem brings upon him, he's going to know this is the ultimate goodness, because I know I'm doing everything I can for Hashem, whatever Hashem does for me, I know that it's the ultimate good for me. כי מי לא ישמח כשנותנים ממנו פרוטות נחושך, says the Rabbi, gives a wonderful parable. Who is not going to be happy that is being taken from him copper coins, ונותנים לו תמורתם כיכר זהב, and he's being given in return a loaf of gold. Who is not going to be happy if he's being taken from him, that somebody's taken from him few coins of copper, in return he's getting a loaf of bread. Of course, you know, the ultimate good, this guy, this partner, this family, this uncle, whatever. Whatever happens to me in my life, I'm being taken a few coins of copper, and I'm going to be given a loaf of bread. Bezrat Hashem, in this life, for sure, in the world to come. Any questions?
So they talk about Esav, like, from one side, he is wicked, but he is getting all these good things that he was getting. And, like, in reality, what does it mean? Because you can say, somebody is wicked, he did something good, everything is good for him. And you're doing something good, like, let's say you observe everything and all the stuff, that it means that you're even higher than him. If he's getting everything, that means you're getting everything. Like, how is that? Like, or just because you do something, you're going to get less than him?
He's getting everything for reward for this world. Rosh Baruch Hu pays the wicked people everything, COD, cash on delivery, because he doesn't want them on the world to come. Say, why? I don't have anything. I did this, and it's no problem. You've received a reward on this world. Don't you see how successful you were? You had big house, big this, big that. But on the other end, for us, for the people who try to be servant of Hashem Tzadikim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu pays us according to perfect us.
So it's better to be a loser in this world.
So we know that this world, according to its foundation of Judaism, this world is a train station, 60, 70, 120 years, and the ultimate reward is for the world to come. But even if you look at this world as very important, because this world is important, because the tzaddikim really care about everything Hashem given them. Yaakov Avinu ran to take the few bottles, he made a big effort to take the big bottle, because Mamono Shel Tzaddik Chaviv Alav, the belonging of a tzaddik is beloved by Imai, because it's a blessing from Hashem. But you have to look at the ultimate picture, that it's everything is done to perfect me. Plus, as Jews, we know it's a foundation of Judaism that we have Gilgul Neshamot. Our Neshamot been here before. And sometimes we do things and we pay for things we did before. Because it's not really pay. It's actually to perfect us and to pay for things that we did before. So for the ultimate Chaye Netzach, the eternity, which is the world to come, it will be good for us. So yes, that's why it's Tzadik Veralo. Rasha Vetovlo. Rasha gets paid many times in this world, because Hashem Meshalem Sachar Leavido. He pays him the rewards to make him last from the world to come. That's why you see Esav got rewarded. That's why you see Nebuchadnezzar got rewarded for small things they did to honor Hashem. To show you, Kal Vachomer, if we honor HaKadosh Baruch Hu, how much reward we have in this world and the world to come.
But at the same time, if we do something like Hilul Hashem, our punishment is greater than, let's say, Esav?
That's a big question. So, she's asking, what happened if a wicked person does Hilul Hashem, or a tzaddik does Hilul Hashem? So if a wicked person does the Hilul Hashem, you can say he's not going to make tshuva on this. In a sense, it's maybe worse. A tzaddik, if he does Hilul Hashem, maybe he's going to make tshuva on this, and also mitah mechaperet, the death is the atonement for Chilul Hashem. Yeah, Chilul Hashem is such a big avera that you can make tshuva on this, but the actual cleansing is when a person passes away. So mitah is a big kapara. The person dies, but Hashem, we should all live long life. His death is kapara for Chilul Hashem, for things that he did are so severe. Chilul Hashem is the main thing. That only the death, the losing of the body and the separation, it's what mekaper al chilul Hashem. A person needs to be aware of what he did all the time. Chatati negdi tamid. My sins are in front of me always, that I know what I did, and I need to make atonement, to make kapara, to vidu it. Of course, things that you make tshuva, you make tshuva. But we always have to try to become better. We should remember that some averot like chilul Hashem, the actual ceiling, if a person did tshuva on it, the actual ceiling of the being erased from him is when he's passing away from this world.